Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Desmond Payne Road to the Show. It's time to resume Desmond's journey here with the Texas Rangers, after a break from the series while I focused mainly on the Chargers franchise. Many of you have wanted to see more of this series, and it's a series I have really enjoyed when I've focused on it. I don't want to have any more big breaks with this series. It's time to give this Road to the Show the time and energy I think it deserves. So let's recap this a bit. Of course, Desmond Payne suffered a fractured shin earlier in spring training, missed the first couple months of the season, but then came back and looked just as strong as he did in the spring training, including reuniting with third base here on this slide, the same play he got injured on. It was a cool moment to see him come back from the injury and go right back to third base and still show off the power that he showed in spring training. Now, there was an episode set to be made after the latest episode, but the gameplay was deleted after I forgot about it for so long, so there's a lost episode that you won't be able to see. There were some really good games in there. There was a triple and a home run game, so you don't see the second home run of the season for Desmond Payne, and he had a good game against Felix Hernandez as well. But it's time to get back to Desmond's journey, and of course, him in the field has always been a journey. Here in Toronto, he's going back to the wall. This is a really dangerous spot. He dives and cannot glove the ball. It goes right off the palm, it appears. Payne finally gets it back in, but the Blue Jays get a run across. If that could have been a little faster, maybe you save the run there. Of course, it would have been nice to make that catch in the first place. So Toronto up 9-4 as Payne strikes out later in the game. Not having a good stretch of games here. He went 1-for-5 in this one. And immediately after, they hadn't even left the stadium, it looks like, and they trade away Shin-Soo Choo. This is a huge move. I'm not sure if it was motivated by salary or what, but they acquired a AAA pitcher, Chris Kelly, making $70,000 this year at 65 overall with B potential. I'm having a hard time making sense of that move. And this trade effectively means that Desmond Payne is a more important part of the offense. He delivers on this one a great swing. I always love watching these hits the other way going down the line. A really nice job here by Desmond Payne, giving that some carry down the line, safely on the right side of the chalk. So a double there for Payne, and the next batter is Prince Fielder. And he's lifting this one high and hard to deep right for a two-run home run. Now for the good part of this series, the offense has been revolved around Payne, Fielder, and Shin-Soo Choo. Now that outfield spot seems to be taken by Sean Galvan, who was with Payne at AAA. Later in the game, Payne goes up the middle with a base hit and drives in another run. So having himself a nice day, and there is Sean Galvan, who already hit a homer earlier. Bases loaded, two down, and this gets through the middle, and Payne will round third on his way, being the second one to score. So in the first game after the Choo trade, it looks okay for the Texas offense. They're winning this one 8-2 in the fourth inning. And then Desmond Payne, deep right center and gone. His third homer of the season, I believe the 10th of his career in the majors. A really impressive outing for the offense as Payne is 3-for-3 with a single, double, and a home run in time to get that triple. Let's go into the fifth. It's 11-5. Is Texas done scoring? Well, here's a dribbler by Payne. It stays fair out at third, and Payne is safe at first, so he can't get it that time. Let's go into the eighth. Still 11-5, and now a weak ground ball to the right side. Payne retired. So in the eighth inning, you assume that is his last AB, but we're going to go back to the field. And we saw Payne trying to track down a play, couldn't make it. Now we're going to see his arm. This has also been an issue, and the rainbow comes up short and takes the catcher off the spot. At least, Payne gets one more shot in the ninth inning for the cycle. Man on first, two down, and Payne draws a walk. I don't like that location they're up in. It could have been called a strike. So Payne does not get the cycle, but a 3-for-5 day with a homer and two RBIs. You have to be happy with that. Yu Darvish gets the W. We'll continue on in this series against Toronto. By the way, the outfield now is Payne in center as he lines out to short. Leonis Martin in right and Sean Galvan in left. 4-0 Toronto, though, in the third inning as Payne takes a pitch off of Michael Pineda, who spent a really short amount of time in Texas last year. Payne would be stranded, though, on that strikeout. Ahead to the fifth inning, still looking for their first run of the day as Payne has the count evened up here with two down. Runner at second as he swings through the slider and heads back to the bench after that strikeout. We're going to jump into the ninth inning as Texas scored two here ahead of Payne's at bat. And this is not fielded cleanly and Payne reaches, putting runners at the corners with two outs. Up is Leonis Martin, who was 2-for-3. Could Martin extend the game? Payne takes off for second. They throw that way and Payne is there just ahead of the throw. A base hit could tie the game. But an 0-2 count. Fly ball lifted to right, routine, and caught to end the game. Texas drops this series to Toronto, 2-1, and we head on to the series against the Boston Red Sox in Fenway, a 4-game set with only 7 games to go until the All-Star break. Already almost halfway done in Payne's second year because of that injury. This looks good off the bat, right? Well, looks can be deceiving, and it fooled me. I didn't even want to change the perspective there because I wanted to see it hit off the green monster from that view. Obviously nowhere near far enough. Jumping ahead into the seventh inning, a 1-2 count, and Payne gets jammed. Somehow hits this into right, and it gets caught. Not a trap catch out there. And Payne goes 0-for-5 in the first game of this series as they out-hit the Red Sox 19-4. A great offensive output. I mean, maybe this offense didn't need Chu to be good, but I guess we'll see in the long run if that is the case. Payne having a rough stretch of games, despite a couple good ones against Toronto. So here in Game 2 against the Sox, Payne battling here as the second batter. The count is full, and then he swings through a fastball on the outside for strike 3, a 9-pitch strikeout. Let's go into the second. Bases juiced as Payne can't catch up to that heater, and then swings through a sinker. A lot of these swings seem to be pretty close, but Payne not connecting in a bit of a slump overall. It's 5-1 Red Sox as Texas could not capitalize on early opportunities. And here is Payne weakly hitting one to second, and the throw is in time to get him out and give him his second 0-for-5 in a row. Payne did have an RBI in that game, but needs to get on base more. So here is Game 3 against the Red Sox. And Payne hits this into the right center gap. Perfect spot as Payne rounds first. Will he go to third on this one? Not this time. But a double for Payne. He eventually moves to third. And here is a hit deep left. And this one will go off the green monster and drive in Payne and another run. Texas went up 3-0 in the first, but here are the Red Sox loading the bases. Here's a hit into the gap. Payne trying to track it down, and he does. A tumbling grab in the gap. However, it allows a runner to tag. 7-1 anyway as we go into the fourth inning. The offense again delivering, and Payne a big part of it. Right center bouncing over that short wall for his second double of the game. He likes that right center gap quite a bit. And here is a fly ball into right. Payne this time will not be driven in, but the Rangers did not need that run as they win 7-4. The Sox took the first two games of this series. The Rangers won the third, and then Payne had an off day as they make another trade. This team is always trading somebody. The only player I can think of they acquired that has had a really good impact has been Jamal Weeks. So I'd like to see them maybe pull back from the trades a bit. Last series before the All-Star break, and that's taken away from Desmond Payne. It wouldn't have been a homer, but it could have been at least a double. Spectacular play against the wall as Payne nearly had a big hit here against Chris Archer. Here's his second go around as he goes to left for a base hit. Good swing there, just took what Archer gave him. The next hitter, though, one down, and here is a tough play at short, but they end up turning two. Really good defense here by the Rays, but it wasn't enough as they dropped this game just a 2-0 game with 11 combined hits. Chris Archer at 3-8, by the way, on the season. And that leaves us with one more game to go this year as Payne had another off day. They ended up losing, so trying to take this series ahead of the break. They have Payne here in the one spot hitting 257 because of some of these slumping games. But Payne trying to raise that average. That gets down and left, just barely. So the base hit there will help his cause as he's on first base with one down. And here is Fielder, deep right center, and Payne can just run. That is plenty far enough as Payne goes for a nice jog around the bases. A little hesitation there, but then he gets going again to home and ends up scoring on the RBI from Prince Fielder. Now this was another low-scoring game. We're jumping all the way into the ninth. 2-2. Two down as Payne is trying to make something happen with the bases clear. A 2-2 count and a foul tip, strike three. This game would go into extras, and here is Payne in the 12th. Still a 2-2 game, nobody on base. Payne batting as a righty, and he puts this down the line and right, and it gets down again just in front of the outfielder. Two hits of similar variety in this one. Two on later for the Rangers as this is hit into right center. And it looks like a decent spot for Payne to tag. He's fast, so he takes off. The relay throw comes in a hair late. That was a little closer than you would like to see, but Payne is 90 feet from taking the lead for Texas. However, a strikeout from Harry Riley ends the inning. And this game would just keep on going. Every now and then there were hits and runners getting into scoring position, but those opportunities were being shut down. This game continued on. Let's go into the 14th inning. Same score and Payne popping up into foul territory. Come on, Desmond. That is it for this opportunity, but it wasn't Payne's last. Top of the 16th inning. Runner in scoring position, one down, and Payne grounding to the right side. Advancing the runner. Could Texas finally take the lead? Here is Leonis Martin. Oh, that's over the dugout. Watch out. A full count. Martin grounding to third. The throw to first in time to end the 16th inning. It wouldn't end. However, in the 17th, with two runners on, finally, runs came through as Ben Cabrera hit the game-winning home run for the Rangers. And that's gotta suck to go to like a home game and have almost twice as many innings as you would expect and still watch a loss. Do they even serve food and drinks in the extra innings? Like, I don't know if they do. But anyway, that is it for this episode. We are now at the All-Star break. Payne's average isn't where I would like it right now, but hopefully he is geared up for a strong second half of the season. The rest of the offense pretty much is on a hot streak right now. And we'll see if they take a dip at any point without Shin-Soo Choo, who is now on the Nationals. By the way, the player we acquired for him, Chris Kelly, I am assuming it happened after the trade, but he's on the DL right now with a head fracture. Oh, 4 to 5 months, so his season is over. We're not going to get to see him for a long time, it seems. But we will see more Desmond Payne later this week as we continue this season. After the All-Star festivities, it opens up at home against the Royals and the Athletics. And we'll get back to this Desmond Payne road of the show and get going strong. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave a like, leave your feedback down below. Let me know what you think of this series and subscribe to the channel. I will see you all later. Have a great day.